A very happy morning, students. We are ready with one more question, and this time the question is related with our fifth chapter, that is emerging modes of business. This time when we are discussing about these chapter, this is related with the risk which we are facing, with the businessmen are facing. For that only this topic is related. Now we will just go through the question and we will see that about what they are asking, what type of risk is being faced, that we will discuss over here. Now let us see the question first. What it has said: Infotech Limited is running a website for selling its gift item. So what, this is a common thing nowadays. People are making the websites and uploading the pictures of the gift, the items, whatever they are selling on the website. So what it has done, it has just uploaded the pictures of gift items on the site and getting order from all over the country. Recently, company got the order of 100 pieces of a particular gift item. Now, what happened here? Infotech has opened a website. On the website, he has just uploaded all the pictures of his gift item, and later on, it has got order of 100 gift item. Okay, so till here, I have no confusion. Now, what we are saying? Infotech delivered it on time, so that is very good. But the company who has placed the order has returned it. You see here, but the company returned it and said that they ordered some other item. So this is one risk which is faced by a company. Here, Infotech has received the order, it has delivered the thing on time also. Then also the goods are being returned, and the company which is the purchaser, it has returned on the ground that it has ordered something else. Now here the question, if you see, the question is, state the risk faced by Infotech. If you remember, in case of e-business, there are three risks categorized. The risk has been categorized into three parts. Transaction risk is one of the risks among them. Now the another risk, if we say, that is data storage and transmission risk. This is the second risk, and the third risk is risk to threat of intellectual property and privacy. So three types of risk were there. Right now we are talking about the first risk, because here you see the goods which is being delivered is being claimed by the other company is something else which is delivered. This was the name, not same, which has been ordered. So if you remember, this is about the transaction risk. Yes, this is about the transaction risk. Now when we are talking about transaction risk, if you remember, there transaction risk is being categorized into three parts: default on order, default on delivery, and default on payment. Default on order means what will happen there, the customer will deny that I have not placed the order, and seller may deny that I have not received the order. So it is about placement and receipt of the order. So this is default of order. Default of payment, again the same thing. The seller will say that I have not received the payment, and the purchaser will say that I have made the payment. So this is the default on payment. But default on delivery exactly say that the goods may be delivered to some other place, or it may also happen that whatever is being ordered, something else is being delivered. And you see here, this is the same case. The company which has placed the order is claiming that it has not placed the same order which is being delivered to them. That is why they have returned the order. It means to say this is related with the transaction risk and default on delivery. The risk here which you can see, that is default on delivery. Okay? So transaction risk, default on delivery, default on delivery and transaction risk. Now when we are talking about the other question, if you say state other risks related to the business, that means they are asking about the other risks. Except this, what are the other risks which is being faced? So right now in the beginning only I have told you that except transaction risk, there are two more risks. In the beginning only I have told there are three types of risk, three categories of risk. Transition, when the transition is going on, that time what type of risk can be faced? Okay, so this is one thing, and here the question is related with the transition risk only, because the goods which have been ordered, something else has been delivered. Next one is data storage and transmission risk. That means when the data is being stored there or when the data is being transmitted, that time also the risk is there. Now, whenever we are connecting to internet, lot of danger you can see. One thing is that somebody can send the virus in your system. Your file can be targeted. Your complete system can be damaged. This is one thing which is possible. Another thing is that hacking, which is very much known to us. Somebody can just get the information, whatever they require from our system. They can steal the data. So that is hacking. So this type of risk is the another category, that is data storage and transmission risk. That means when the data is stored or when we are sending the data from one device to another device, this type of risk may arise. So transmission risk is no doubt one risk. Another risk is data storage and transmission risk. And third risk is risk to threat of property and intellectual property. Now, when we are talking about the third risk, as I told you right now, risk of threat to intellectual property, and one more one is there, privacy. Yes, risk of threat to intellectual property and privacy. Now, when we are talking about intellectual property, maybe our copyright, our patent, whatever we have kept safely, someone can hack the data from our device and that can be stolen. This is possible. Similarly, our privacy is also on the edge, because suppose if you are sending the mail to somebody, and what you will say when you will open your account, and lot of junk mails and spams are there. So we are just tired by seeing all those extra messages and advertisements, because what will happen whenever we are going internet, our email address is now available to most of the people, and they can dump a lot of information. Suppose if I am searching on a particular website, and they may ask about our email address, and later on what they will do, lot of promotional items, promotional informations, they will put it in our inbox. So that is a really big problem. It is we can't say that this is one relaxing one. We feel so much tired when we want to search for a particular email, and a lot of emails are present over there. So this is one of the tiring thing. So you can see here this risk, transmission risk, except that two more risk: data storage and transmission risk, and threat to intellectual property and privacy. So these are the total risk and all the concerned thing. Hope so the question is clear to you. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.